Hi, all curious and serious people. I am Robbie here from Matescium with a lot of fun with mathematics. This time, I'm gonna to prove that 1 plus 1 is equal to 0. I'm not kidding you at all, be sure. Really, I will prove through mathematics that 1 plus 1 is equal to 0. If you did not subscribe me, hit the subscribe button now. It will inspire me a lot to make more qualityful video. In order to prove that 1 plus 1 is equal to 0, I have to go through this calculation. What we know from our primary school that 1 plus 1 is equal to 2, right? We know 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. There is no tricks or nothing here. We know it from our primary school. I can just modify this equation as like this way. Left hand side is 1 plus 1. I'm eliminating minus 1 from left hand side and again eliminating minus 1 from right hand side. See, 1 plus 1 here, minus 1 is extra that I am eliminating from left hand side, and 2 from the previous line and minus 1 from extra that I am eliminating here, because this minus 1 from left hand side, this minus 1 from left hand side, they balance the previous equation. Next line, I can say I can keep this left hand side completely same, 1 plus 1 minus 1 is equal to, I'm giving a square root, then 2 minus 1 from previous line, and then for square root I'm giving a square here, right? So why square and square root? I'm explaining a little bit. If we use square root and square together, that means they are neutral, they're supported by the previous line. So this line is supported by the previous line. According to the mathematical statement, the square root is the inverse operation of square. So don't worry, this line is supported by this line. There is no mathematical tricks. Maybe you know that. I'm keeping the left hand side completely same once again. 1 plus 1 minus 1 is equal to square root. And then look at here. 2 minus 1 whole square. That means there is a formula. We know now it's time to play with formula. What is our formula? Our formula is x square minus y square. Sorry, I'm writing the wrong formula. X minus y whole square is equal to x square minus 2xy plus y square. That we know from our high school level. Maybe you can remember this formula. X square minus 2xy plus y square is equal to x minus y whole square. So see, x minus y, this is x minus y, this is completely similar, so I can expand this line as this formula. What we are getting, 2 square minus 2 times 2 times 1 plus 1 square, right? Hopefully you understand how did I get this. Now keep the same left hand side, 1 plus 1 minus 1 is equal to square root, 2 square is equal to 4, minus 2 times 2 times 1 is 4 plus 1 square equals 1. Again, I'm keeping the left hand side same, 1 plus 1 minus 1 equals square root. If you 4 minus 4 plus 1 is equal to 1, we know this line equivalent to square root 1. I'm again keeping the left hand side same, 1 plus 1 minus 1 equals square root remaining minus 1 square, because you know whatever minus 1 square is equal to plus 1. So this is applying here exactly, minus 1 square is equal to plus 1. So minus 1 square is equal to plus 1. Next line is, again I'm keeping the left hand side same, 1 plus 1 minus 1 equals to, you can see this part is going to vanish, That means square root is inverse of square. So I can write only minus. That is no problem. Hope you can understand. Again, I am telling you, this square root and this square, they can be vanished together, because you know square root is a inverse function or inverse operator of this square. That I already told you. So remaining is this minus 1. Minus 1 is here. You can see this minus 1 from left hand side and this minus 1 from right hand side, they can vanish, and remaining is 1 plus 1 is equal to 0. So I'm proof once again that 1 plus 1 is equal to 0. Question is, how did I prove that? Right? Of course, I somewhere skipped the ground rules of mathematics here, somewhere in my entire calculation. You can have a look carefully and try to find out where I did not follow the ground rules of mathematics. This is pretty funny, be sure, because normally 1 plus 1 is not equal to 0 according to the mathematics. I skip or miss some steps in this whole calculation. For that reason, I got this strange result. Please don't take it seriously, because this is only for fun. If you take it seriously, then you will be puzzled and your head will be spin. Just take it fun and try to find out where I did not follow the ground rules of mathematics in this entire calculation. If you find it, please write it in the comment section, or whatever you want to discuss, please write it in the comment section. Thank you so much for your attention and watching my video. And I made one more video, and that I prove that 2 plus 2 is equal to 5. Normally what we know, 2 plus 2 is equal to 4, but I prove that 2 plus 2 is equal to 5. This is very interesting video. You can have a look. I already set it in the description, this link of this video. You can have a look. And not only this, but also I prove on again that $1 is equal to 1 cent. This is another video. This is also another exciting and very interesting video. You can have a look that $1 I prove equals to 1 cent according to the mathematics. But this is only for the fun. Don't take it seriously, please. And yeah, that's all for this week. And if you are not my subscriber, please subscribe my channel. You will get the new exciting video every Tuesday at 2 o'clock in German time. Yeah, I hope you will enjoy my video, and you are enjoying my video right now. Thank you so much for watching my video, and see you on next time with new exciting and different videos. Bye bye.